Okay, today we are going to start with the, in this lecture we will try to cover the group 1 basic radical. Okay, first we will try to understand the identification algorithm. Okay, algorithm in the sense we will do one step, we will get some result. If not, if yes, if okay, what is the process? If not, then what is the other process? Okay, so this is what the basic difference when you study other chapter. This is a decision making chapter. Okay, so you cannot understand just by going through the reactions. So you have to follow the sequence and understand the algorithm, then only your scoring will be there. Okay, so before that, group 1 contains how many basic radical? Group 1 contains how many basic radicals? 3 basic radicals. Okay, group 1 of this contains 3 basic radical. What are those? First one is PB, okay, PB2 positive. Second one is HG2, 2 positive, HG2, 2 positive, okay. So HG2, 2 positive, and third one is silver positive, okay. Group radicals of the first group, group radicals of first group are PB2 positive, HG2 2 positive, AG2 AG positive. Okay, these three are combinedly called as what? Group 1 basic radical. Now the group reagent, every group contains some limited number. Okay, some limited number of what? Basic radical and one common group reagent. Here that group reagent is HCl. Okay, so how to remember? Already I told you, aage hoga PUBG, aage hoga PUBG. Is it understood? So first group AG, HG, PB. Okay, so group reagent is what? HCl. When it is treated with the HCl, there can and white precipitate will be formed. Okay, so what is the algorithm? If out of the 6 groups and 0 group, total 7 groups, when you are reacting the given salt with HCl, if white precipitate is there, that means preliminary test is over. What is a preliminary test? The given salt may contain PB2 plus, HG2 2 plus and AG plus. Okay, so it can be PB2 plus, HG2 2 plus and AG plus. It can be preliminary test. Okay, now then we will pour the hot water into it. What we will add? We will add hot water. Okay, so again there will be 2 parts. So like this, this is called as a, what do you call it, as a algorithm. If we are doing this, if it is okay, then not okay, then like that. We are going to study this white precipitate is there. So if either 2 parts are there, okay, that precipitate may dissolve. Okay, so precipitate do not dissolve. There are 2 chances. There are only how many chances? 2 chances. Okay, that white precipitate formed in the reaction with HCl of the salt, if it is dissolved in the hot water, if it is dissolved in the water, what we have to confirm? If it is does not dissolve in the water, what you have to confirm? Okay, so if it is dissolving in the water, the out of these 3 salt, it can be PB plus 2. Okay, so if it does not dissolve, if does not dissolve, do not dissolve, it can be HG2 2 plus and it can be AG2 AG plus. Is it understood? Sequence, is it understood? Procedure only you have to identify. So group 1 basic radical contains 3 3 basic radicals, and which when treated with HCl confirms out of them white precipitate. Out of the many basic radical, they can be these 3. Okay, so out of these 3, which is PB, which is, whether it is HG2 positive or AG positive, that we are going to do it through the confirmatory test. Up to here, what test? Only preliminary test. Here we are sure, almost 99% sure that it can be PB plus 2. Okay, but we are not 1%, still we are having a doubt. Okay, so do not dissolve. So it can be preliminary for the HG2 2 plus. Is it clear? HG2 2 plus and AG plus. So now we are going to do the confirmatory test. If dissolve, what we have to do? If does not dissolve, what we have to do? If dissolve, different colors may be there. So according to that, confirmatory test will be done. Okay. So before proceeding further, make a note of it. Okay, this is the second part of the algorithm. We have reacted the given salt with HCl. Then we found that white precipitate is there. And then it is heated with, after that, then it is heated with what? It is heated with the hot water. Okay, that white precipitate, whichever it is formed, if it is dissolving. So preliminary test shows that it may be Pb2 positive. It may be, if that white precipitate formed in the earlier reaction is able to dissolve in hot water, it can be due to the Pb2 positive. So to confirm that, whatever the dissolved solution is there, let us take 30 ml. Okay, the 30 ml of dissolved solution made it into three parts. Three parts because we wanted to confirm in three times. Okay, three different way we wanted to confirm. This is confirmatory test. Okay. So it is not compulsory. Suppose we got two confirmatory tests, we will do it into two parts. If we got seven confirmatory tests, then we will do it seven parts. More number of confirmatory tests you will do, more will be the assurance. Okay. So is it understood? It is only, that's why I'm using the word preliminary. Okay. Preliminary, then we will use the word maybe. Is it understood? Now here after this, finally, it will be. So there is a lot of difference, maybe and it will be, okay, or it is. So the best word is I can, I will, understood? So if somebody asks, you will say, so I may get, I may admitted, okay, like that. If you say that, the other person will not be get confidence in you. Same way, up to here, we don't have confidence, whether it may be Pb2 positive or it may be something else also. After the end of this, we are confirmed. Understood? So that 10 ml, 10 ml and 10 ml. That 10 ml first treated with, first part, that is 10 ml treated with potassium dichromate. Okay? So this will form the yellow precipitate. Okay? So yellow precipitate, if it is there, it can be due to what? PbCrO4, lead chromate. Okay, so that lead chromate yellow precipitate, now we got 99%. Let us reach up to the what? 100% surety. So then that yellow precipitate treated with NaOH. Okay, if it is able to react with that, okay, so if it is able to react with that to form sodium plumbate, okay, Na2PbO2, then it is 100% sure from this part. Okay. So we will again confirm, because here LOPPT is there. So LOPPT can be lead chromate, LOPPT can be lead iodide. Okay. Because second part we are going to treat it with potassium iodide. So lead 2 positive of the given salt react with potassium iodide of our added reagent to form yellow colored PbI2. Then if you still add some more potassium iodide, then it is going to dissolve to form K2PbI4. Okay. So this is again, we are getting confirmed. Third part, third confirmatory test. The third part, it is simply cooled. Okay. So it is, when it is heated in the hot water, kept in the hot water, it was dissolving. Okay. But after cooling, if the white precipitate which was there, if it reappears. So here we are 100% sure that the given salt will contain Pb2 positive. Is it understood? So flow chart on the left part only. First we are treated the given salt with the HCl, white precipitate is formed, that white precipitate heated with the hot water dissolved. Then first part potassium dichromate, yellow precipitate followed by sodium chromate. Okay, and sodium plumbate. Second part is treated with potassium iodide, yellow precipitate again dissolved when excess potassium iodide. Okay. Third part re-cooled again, white color disappeared. After this, these are the confirmatory tests. Before that, it was only preliminary test. Okay. Is it understood? The algorithm of PB plus 2, any doubt about it? So now you make only this part, okay? But if you have interest and you wanted to explore a great career, you get the A3 size paper, okay? A3 size paper, all confirmatory tests should be written on the horizontal landscape format, including PB2 positive, including AG positive, and including HG2 positive should be in one place in the landscape format. Let's see who can do it, okay? Okay, we are in the second part of algorithm. White precipitate when dissolved in hot water, still some part, if it is not dissolving, it can be AG or it can be HG. Understood? So that if it is AG and HCl, what it will form? HG, AgCl. If that HCl and if it is HG2 positive, so HG2Cl2 will be there. Okay. So to confirm, differentiate silver or mercury, the reagent we are going to use is ammonium hydroxide. Okay. This ammonium hydroxide already we have studied in one of the tests. So if you remember, then it is easy. Understood? So ammonium hydroxide, if that precipitated part, if it is reacted with ammonium hydroxide, precipitate plus ammonium hydroxide, then if precipitate dissolves, then it can be AgCl. It can be what? AgCl. It can be preliminary test. Okay. So that precipitate is not dissolved in ammonium hydroxide also, not dissolved in hot water also, not dissolved in ammonium hydroxide also, but that color changed from white color to black color PPT. Okay. So it may be due to Hg plus HgNH2Cl. It may be due to what? Hg plus HgNH2Cl. It may be. Okay. So this is up to here only preliminary test. Up to here we are sure that it may be Ag but not Hg. And here we are sure that it may be Hg2+, but not confirm that it is only Hg2+. Okay. So to confirm this, confirmatory test is further divided into four parts. So we will make this dissolved precipitate into how many parts? Four parts. And one part will react with the different reagent. Here, one part only. Okay. So what is that confirmatory test we are going to study now? Understood? So whatever I teach it to you, you will write it here. After that, whatever I teach it to you will write here. Is it understood, our algorithm? Okay. So note down this. After that, what you will do? You will write whatever I will tell you, you will write it here, you will write it here, four parts, okay? Then I will tell you, then you can write it here, okay? So this is Hg. This is Hg plus HgNH2Cl. Hg plus HgNH2Cl. Is it at least audible now? HgNH2Cl. Okay, is it clear? Okay, we are in the left part of the dissolved precipitate. Okay, what is this dissolved precipitate? Dissolved precipitate is due to soluble complex. Okay, there was a previous question. The dissolved precipitate is due to which of the formula of the dissolved precipitate? Okay. So there is a soluble complex, silver plus ammonical silver chloride. What it is? Ammonical silver chloride. Actually, this is a complex up to here. AgNH3O twice Cl. So because of this, it was dissolved. Understood? So we will make that dissolved precipitate into how many parts? Four parts. First part is treated with HNO3. Then white color, white precipitate reappears. What it will become? White precipitate reappears. It shows the presence of silver. Okay, what it will show? It will show the presence of silver. Okay, then the second part we have collected out of it is treated with potassium iodide. Then yellow precipitate will come. Which precipitate will come? Yellow precipitate. What is the formula of that yellow precipitate? AgI. What is that? AgI. Then second part is, third part is treated with potassium. These are the common reagents. See, already we have used in the lead also. Okay. So common reagent K2CrO4, there it was PbCrO4 formed, here it is Ag2CrO4 will be forming, okay, and it is brick red color. Which red color? Brick red color. H2S also we have used there, and here it will form the black precipitate. It is further treated with the HNO3, which results in formation of nitric oxide. Okay, so this is how we confirmed about the presence of which silver precipitate. Silver is present in our salt. Okay, so two things are confirmed. What is that? Lead is confirmed and silver is confirmed. Now we are left with one more thing. What is that? We are left with Hg2 2+. Okay, how to confirm it? Confirmatory test we are going to study it now. Before that, you note down this. Where you will note down? Left part of that. Okay, so try to, if you are having a long notebook, try to keep it in the landscape like this. So try to write it here. Understood? So you may not be aware, initially I have not told, that is also my mistake. Okay, now onwards, next group onwards, you can make notes like this. Otherwise, it is better if you write it in the A3 sheets. Okay, so that will be the best way to memorize the things at one glance. Okay, number of glances you improve, the more memory it will occupy. So try to reduce the glances by increasing the page size. Okay, so we are in the final part of the group 1 basic radical. They are the final part of the group 1 basic radical. What is that final part? To identify the mercury. Okay, so when we added the NH4OH, one part was dissolved, another part was black precipitate. What is the formula of that black precipitate we obtained? Hg plus Hg NH2Cl. It was not soluble. Okay, but we are not going to leave that precipitate. We treated with aqua regia. All of you must be aware about the aqua regia formula. What is the formula? It is a mixture of 3 moles of HCl plus 1 part of HNO3. Okay, this mixture is called as a aqua regia. Very important point, already studied in our P block also. Okay, aqua regia is a 3 parts HCl and 1 part HNO3. Is it clear? 1 part HNO3, 3 part HCl. Okay, so which was not soluble in ammonium hydroxide and formed black precipitate. Now when it is dissolved in aqua regia, it is soluble. Okay, soluble because HgCl, this Hg is converted to now HgCl. Okay, HCl reacted and formed as a aqua regia. Is the one of the best solvent in the universe. It is able to dissolve even noble metal like gold also. Okay, so once it can dissolve noble metals, and this white black precipitate is very minute small thing in front of it. Okay, so it can dissolve great noble metals also. Okay, so soluble HgCl when treated with the SnCl2, first it will form white PPT. Okay, first it will form white PPT, which is due to Hg2Cl2. Okay, again after that, after some time, it will convert back into black due to the mercury. Okay, SnCl2, first it is converted into Hg2Cl2, further reduced to black PPT. Then when soluble solution made into two parts, one part is treated with the SnCl2, another part is treated with the potassium iodide. Okay, so potassium iodide orange precipitate is formed. What precipitate is formed? Orange precipitate is formed. The formula of the orange precipitate is HgI2. What is the formula? Orange precipitate is HgI2. Then precipitate, if we add some more potassium iodide to that precipitate, it will form red precipitate. This is very, very V to the power of infinity important. Already we have studied about this in our zero group also. What is that group? What is this called as? Red PPT KOH plus K2HgI4 is called as. What it is called as? The combination of KOH plus K2HgI4. Okay. So this shows that you have not studied. Those who are not able to answer, that means they have to go through the zero group, just lecture before this. Okay. So if you have any problem, what you will do? You will search which chem zero group. Okay. Then speciality two reagents are told to you. In that zero group, there are two things very, very important. One is this one, another is that one. Okay. So let us see answer. Okay, this is one Nessler reagent. It is an important part of that lecture. One more thing also I told you in that lecture, very, very important. What is that substance? Along with the structure, I have explained in the zero group. Other than the Nessler reagent, it is some basic substance. And it is in some dollars. Very good. That is Millen's base. Okay. Millen's base and Nessler reagent are very important topics of the zero group basic radical identification. Okay.